Aloha, I'm your Minivan Dyken MD from Out of the Doldrums. Here on this channel, we love to talk about nitric oxide and everything related to nitric oxide. We've discussed nitric oxide as an antiviral molecule against all sorts of viruses, even against COVID. We've also discussed a new line of defense against respiratory infections, nasal nitric oxide spray. I'll link all the videos on this in the description below. In my opinion, they're worthwhile watching. Today, we'll be reviewing a recent study on this same nitric oxide nasal spray. In my opinion, this study does a very nice job displaying the efficacy of nitric oxide nasal spray in clearing the coronavirus from the airways. Let's take some time to review it. This paper is titled, quote, SARS-CoV-2 Accelerated Clearance Using a Novel Nitric Oxide Nasal Spray, NONS, Treatment, a Randomized Trial. It was published in the Lancet Regional Health Southeast Asia in July 2022. Before we dive into the details of this study though, let's review what we already know about nitric oxide and COVID. There's evidence from multiple sources, including book citations and journal publications, that demonstrate the antiviral effect of nitric oxide. Way back in 2021, a phase 2 trial was conducted in the UK by a company called Sanitize. So for the record, I am not affiliated with this company in any way. I don't receive any monetary gifts from them. I don't get any sort of commission. I'm doing this because I'm genuinely interested in nitric oxide nasal spray. This study demonstrated that intranasal nitric oxide administration was found to be effective and safe in reducing the viral load in patients with mild, symptomatic COVID-19 infection. They also found that symptom resolution was faster in the study group. Following this, Sanitize, in conjunction with a company in India that is manufacturing and distributing the spray, created and performed a phase 3 trial further examining the beneficial effects of nitric oxide nasal spray. So let's take a minute to face some brutal facts here. I'm sorry. COVID remains an ongoing global concern. It's been going on for so long. Like, we're all so tired of it. But despite any COVID fatigue that we may have, the virus is still going strong. It's replicating and mutating into all these sorts of variants, mutating to the point that our vaccines can't even keep up. As a result, we're still looking for a good solution, a reliable way to protect ourselves. Please don't get me wrong here. I'm still a huge believer in the importance of hand washing, mask wearing in appropriate scenarios, and vaccination. This nasal nitric oxide spray is an adjunct to this. This is something we can do in addition to all the other stuff. So how exactly does nitric oxide work? When it comes to COVID and all of its variants, nitric oxide is agnostic. It kills all sorts of viruses, bacteria, fungi, helminths, protozoa, and it's a promising compound. It paints with a broad brush. Antiviral effects have been described against both DNA and RNA viruses, including herpes virus, Coxsackie virus, and hantavirus. Laboratories studying COVID have demonstrated immediate virucidal action of nitric oxide against all variants of concern. So it kills all the variants. Here's a paper from Sweden demonstrating just that, nitric oxide killing the SARS-CoV-2 virus in vitro. How exactly does it do this? Well, it does something called nitrosylation and palmitoylation reduction. A tiny bit technical, let's break it down quickly. We all know SARS-CoV-2 has this infamous spike protein on it, you know, the spike, the one. The nitric oxide molecule interferes with the fusion of the spike protein to its receptor on our cells. When it interferes, it slows down viral protease activity, which inhibits the viral RNA from replicating. So basically, the nitric oxide molecule stops the virus from replicating or dividing. In addition to this, the nitric oxide nasal spray is acidic, so its low pH helps the spray to be more antiviral. Lastly, the spray has hypromellose, which is this thick, gooey, and acidic molecule. This allows it to form a protective barrier and allows the spray to trap the virus more efficaciously. So it's not just nitric oxide. Both the acidity and the hypromellose in the spray enhance and augment the antiviral activity of nitric oxide. Okay, so back to the study. This was a phase 3 randomized double-blind placebo-controlled trial. This is pretty much the best trial design scientists can possibly create. Researchers selected 306 subjects who had tested positive for COVID via a home antigen test. All participants had to be early in their illness, meaning they had to be within 3 days of the start of their symptoms. They also had to fit a certain symptom profile. It was okay if they had a fever, cough, sore throat, malaise, headache, nasal congestion, muscle pain, or GI symptoms. It was okay if they had loss of taste or smell. It was not okay if they had moderate or severe symptoms. So along those lines, they had to have an oxygen saturation of greater than 94% and a respiratory rate of under 24 breaths per minute. So they had to have mild illness. The participants were randomized into two groups, and the positive tests were confirmed via PCR after randomization. All participants received what was considered in India to be standard of supportive care for COVID-19. They were given things like antipyretics, like a medication like Tylenol for fever and pain, anti-cough medicine, and adequate hydration and nutrition. So again, we have our two randomized groups. The trial group was given nitric oxide nasal spray. So basically, two nitric oxide generating ingredients, hypromellose, that gelling agent, and a preservative, which was benzalkylonium chloride. The control group, the other group, was given a placebo, which essentially was saline, and a small amount of the same benzalkylonium chloride as a preservative. Both groups were instructed to self-administer the spray, 2 sprays per nostril, 6 times a day, at least 2 to 3 hours apart while awake for 7 treatment days. Researchers then followed both groups to see how they fared. Their primary objective was to follow the viral levels on PCR testing to see how rapidly the virus was cleared. The secondary objectives were focused on clinical improvement. For example, they followed to see how long it took to clear the virus. They also measured how many subjects demonstrated significant improvement on their World Health Organization symptom scores, as well as the proportion of subjects requiring oxygen or hospitalization. Lastly, they measured safety and tolerability. They were looking for adverse events, and they wanted to make sure the nasal spray was safe. Okay, so how did the two groups fare? The nitric oxide group showed a reduction in viral RNA levels at day 2 and 3 of treatment. This reduction was statistically superior to the change seen in the placebo group. When looking at secondary endpoints, a greater proportion of patients in the nitric oxide group became PCR negative compared to the placebo group. Basically, they found that the group using the nitric oxide nasal spray became PCR negative on day 3, and the placebo group didn't become negative until day 7. This difference was statistically significant. So let's hit that pause button for a moment. I know I said statistically significant, but what does that mean in real life? What does that mean for me if I test positive for COVID and use the nasal spray? It means that I can potentially test negative in 72 hours. I can decrease my contagiousness and get on with my life. I'm back to normal 4 entire days before I would have been normal otherwise. To me, this is huge. This is huge when it comes to worker shortages because of the pandemic, and it's also huge when it comes to decreasing spread. Less people will become infected. And selfishly, it's also huge because it means I get to get back to my amazing, meaningful life 4 days sooner than I would have otherwise. So it's very exciting data. As for safety, which was a secondary objective of the study, no zero zilch, no serious adverse events or side effects were reported. Nitric oxide is a compound that our body naturally produces, so it should have very few, if any, side effects. The biggest adverse effect was nasal discomfort. In reflecting on the spray, one theoretical concern I would have is regarding systemic absorption. What if it gets absorbed into our body systemically? You see, nitric oxide is a vasodilator. It dilates blood vessels. If it's absorbed systemically, it could cause major changes in our hemodynamics, meaning it could cause really low blood pressure or it could cause a headache. Well, good news on that front. Researchers did not see any sign of this. So, what can we gather from this study? First, we can conclude that the spray likely causes a quicker reduction in actual viral particles invading our bodies, meaning quicker clearance of the virus, faster time to feeling better and getting back to normal. Some of you may be wondering, what about vaccination? Is this effect still seen in vaccinated versus unvaccinated people? Lucky for us, researchers did break this down, and it appears they randomized appropriately. In the nasal nitric oxide group, 39.2% had received two doses of the COVID-19 vaccine. In the control group, 37.3% received two doses of the vaccine, so pretty equivalent. The take-home message from this is that overall, researchers found that the spray worked just as well in vaccinated versus unvaccinated subjects. Wait, what? Yeah, that's right. The spray worked very well in unvaccinated subjects who lacked the benefits of vaccine immunity. Very reassuring. Also reassuring is that the researchers found that the spray worked well on vaccinated subjects. There was no impact on the treatment effect if you were vaccinated or unvaccinated. Yet another reason why I love nitric oxide. The molecule just doesn't discriminate. Another question, was the study done during the original strain of COVID or during the variants? If so, how does the spray work against these new variants? We all know the variants have thrown a curveball. They definitely did for the vaccines. So how does the spray work against them? Fortunately, the study was done smack dab in the middle of the Delta and the Omicron waves. So this data does still apply. During the time of the study, 58% of participants were during Delta wave and 42% during the Omicron Delta wave. The spray was still effective regardless of the particular variant. So let's take a minute to discuss the significance of these study findings. It looks like using nitric oxide spray early on in a COVID infection will result in quicker recovery. This can result in decreased use of medical resources, less loss of productivity, meaning like less days gone from work, and most important to me, quicker getting back to your physical, mental, and social life. Time is precious. It's one of those things we just cannot get more of. And getting back to normal faster, honestly, it's priceless to me. Okay, but we're not done yet. This is really only the beginning. The use of nasally administered anti-infective therapies is still in its infancy, and I expect the field to significantly grow in the next 3 to 5 years. For example, nasally administered COVID vaccines are currently under development. Sounds a lot less invasive than traditional vaccination. Also, nasal nitric oxide spray is not expected to be associated with the development of drug resistance or drug-drug interactions. We really can't say that about some of the other COVID therapies. And this is the exciting part. The spray also appears to be effective against other respiratory pathogens, including things like influenza. I can tell you, if I'm on a plane or in an enclosed area where I'm expecting exposure to anything, whether it's COVID, influenza, or some other respiratory virus, having a nasal spray to prevent against infection or minimize the infection length would be invaluable. It's a nice sense of protection, and it comes without other variables or side effects. Honestly, I can't wait for more data to come out on this nasal nitric oxide spray. I really feel like it may be in a new class or a new wave of drugs. I feel like this may be the future in prevention against respiratory infections. All right, it's a wrap. I really hope you learned something valuable and useful from this video. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to show us some real support, subscribe. We love hearing from you. Let me know what you think of the video. Tell me your thoughts on the study. By the way, it's available as a free article online, so anyone can read the entire publication. Once you've read it, let me know what your thoughts are. Until next time, stay safe, stay healthy, and aloha.